Now, let me show you where the problem is. The problem is here, if you can get the cam. The problem is here, all this area here.
The spongy bit.
The spongy bit. So the way I do it, and the way any chef will do in the restaurant or everywhere, you cut it in half, then you cut into quarter.
Mm-hmm.
Then all this part here, okay, gets completely thrown in the bin.
What? Look. That's quite a lot.
Yes. Look at this part here.
Yeah,
if you
totally
can get
porous.
Closer. It's very porous. It's seeds. Seeds give you the bitterness. And this will absorb a lot of oil.
You're not left with nothing left.
Look.
Why didn't you just use a courgette? You can use the whole thing.
You're going to try this one and you see what I mean about it. See, Ollie, fantastic.
It has got a nice flavour, so just like that.
Cut a little bit more, OK? And the way then...
It's quite a lot, actually,
Gino. It's OK. So you look, if you don't want to do like that, do it with a knife. You know, do slowly like that, with a smaller knife. And slowly, slowly, you cut
it
away.
So you're just seeing the skin.
So the skin is what it gets. The other thing is, you need to cook it crispy. So at this point, you cut it like that into three parts,
uh-huh.
OK? And this is more or less the chunks that you want. See, if you're going to go any bigger than that, the aubergine won't fry properly and will be very bitter. So look what I'm doing. You're frying the... I mean...
Is there a courgette in there too?
There is courgettes in there. I'm going to put this one on the chopping board.
Yeah, that's what I want
to try. And for Philip, just add a little bit of salt. Guys, this is hot, yeah? OK? Philip, if they...
Can I have a piece of the courgette?
You want
as well.
To do the courgettes, yeah? So you want to do the
Honestly, do. What are you cooking in?
Okay, what I'm going to do is olive oil, okay? Courgettes and aubergine. That you chop it up and put in there. In there, we're going to put a little bit of red onions. The red onions are nice and sweet. And then I'm going to use pancetta.
Fat and butter in there?
No, it's just oil.
Just olive oil.
You know why it's foaming? Because you're thinking about the butter because it's foaming, right? It's because water from the aubergine and the courgettes releases into the oil, so two things can happen. Or is it going to spit everywhere, or if they get it together, they start to foam.
Oh.
So that's what happens.
Cute.
All right? So what's happened? You put it like that, you start it to fry. You want to do this for about 8-9 minutes. Meanwhile, I just want to show, I got some pasta that has been cooking. I'm using bucatini.
Which
bucatini is like a thick spaghetti with a hole in the middle. So it looks like a straw.
Mm-hmm.
You can actually, if you put it into water, you can use it like a straw.
What's the difference? Why would you use that?
In the old days, this is a very old Roman pasta. In the old days, they used to use bucatini because when there was poverty in Italy, the bucatini looks bigger. So people, they trick your mind so it looks like a bigger plate.
Okay.
So the sauce should technically go a little bit in there.
It doesn't.
A little it does. Mm. Not a lot, but a little it doesn't. Now, what we got here, you're frying everything together.
Yeah.
You know, we're going to have to pretend that this has been going on for 8-9 minutes. Tomatoes, okay? I'm using tomatoes. Let's clear everything up. I want you to be honest at the end with the pasta.
I always am.
To make the traditional Italian sauce, forget about fresh tomatoes. You're going to have to deal with the skin, with the seeds and all of that. Thin tomato. I only use two of them, chopped and cherry. You know you can get the cherry, thin cherry tomato. Look, every supermarket or deli, they got them nowadays. So what you get, people, they come to me, I can't believe that you can get, look, little cherry tomatoes. Look at that. Nowadays, by the way, you can get them without the skin as well, which is great. So, this one, once you fry everything, I would fry this one for another 5 or 6 minutes, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
So, let's pretend that we're done five or six minutes. Look, the cherry tomato goes straight in there. Only if you can mix up.
Not the whole can.
You can use the whole can.
Right.
Usually, you know the other thing that we do in Italy? See all the, in the middle, if you can get in the can here, I don't know which camera to get that, all right? If you can get in the can, there is always sauce left, mm-hmm. all right? My mother, you know what she used to do? She used to put a little bit of water in there, shake it, and then pour it in there.
Yeah,
because that is all the tomato fresh in there, so don't waste. Now, you can use fresh basil to do that. I like sometimes, you know, everybody has a jar of pesto. Pesto has got already the cheese in there. It's got the basil, a few pine kernels. Just put in there. And then what I did, I also put the pesto into a bowl with a little bit of extra virgin olive oil. We're going to drizzle that at the ends.
Wow.
All right?
It looks beautiful. How long do you cook the tomatoes in?
Once the tomatoes are in, 12 to 15 minutes, and the job is done.
It's funny, actually, that you're doing it like that, because...
That's what you get.
Controversially, here we go. I'd like it like that rather than cook right down like that. So you could have it to taste, couldn't you?
Of course. If you like it more, the only problem here, if you do that, make sure that the onions are cooked a little bit more, and the pancetta. But you can have it like this, so the cherry tomato, they don't burst.
A bit more form.
Okay, a little bit more form. Or you can make it into a sauce like this.
Okay.
Right, okay? We're going to have to plate up,
now,
do you know?
Pasta into the sauce. We know the score. Okay, you put in there. You make sure that you mix everything together. And we got 30 seconds to do this.
Yeah.
What
okay.
We have now.
Now, in there, we got some mozzarella. If you can come to me with the mozzarella, what do you want to do? Is to just stir the mozzarella in there. Now, you don't want completely melt the mozzarella.
You have to be really quick now.
Okay. Okay, you put it like that. Then you mix it together. Can I have the plates, the serving plates? So once you mix everything together...
Grab the knives and forks.
Yeah. Then you get the mozzarella that is slightly melting.
That is the moment of truth for the Parmigiana.
Oh, that is the same flavour of a Parmigiana. Parmigiana
di
melanzana.
Oh, yeah, no, it's called that. Sorry, but it is a similar thing.
Similar thing. Very similar thing. I'm going to give you a little bit of the aubergine to put it on top.
Oh, that is lovely.
That is, isn't it?
Would you really say, oh, there's an aubergine in there, I'm not going to have it?
No, no, because... no, I don't dislike it that much. It's just not my favourite. I found it, you know, I find it a bit dull, but this is not. This is an interesting aubergine.
Full of flavour.